Okay, YouTube. So I've got the meter hooked up. I've got the line and neutral from the Variac, which is back inside, hooked up to the line and neutral terminals on the meter. And then I have the line and neutral wires from the load, which are the two outlets, are hooked to the outside two terminals. And then I have my power supply wire. So there's my power supply wire coming off of the constant 120 volt tap. So let's go over here and we'll turn this on. I've got 0 volts, 0 amps, 0 watts. Zeros are good. That's what I wanted to see, is all zeros. And now I can turn up the voltage. There's 1, 2, 5, 10. You can turn the voltage all the way up. There's no glitches anywhere. Current stays at zero. The power stays at zero. I can keep going. Looks like that's the maximum, 166 volts. And no current. No watts. That's what I wanted to see. All zeros. So I think that is a success. So let me get everything shoved in there. I gotta make sure I can shove the meter all the way in the hole. I haven't done that yet with there's two side clips, so I might have to do a little bit of filing to get those to fit in there. I'll show you what it looks like when I get it all buttoned up here. Okay, we got the meter plugged in there. Took a little bit extra filing to get it to fit in the opening there, and everything works. So reading zero is really nice, but I guess I need to check out how this meter reads. How accurate is it? So what I have is, this is an Amprobe. It's their ELS2A. It's a clamp meter accessory, I think is what they call it. Pretty handy little gadget here. It's got a power plug on this end, and it's got a receptacle on that end. And what it does is it brings the line conductor, your hot wire, through here in this X1 loop, and you can run a clamp meter through there and get a times one reading. And then over here they actually have 10 loops of wire, and that's the X10 loop, and you get a 10 times current reading. So let me plug that in. I've got the cord here plugged into my light bar, and I've got a 60 watt incandescent bulb, and you can see there we've got about 60 watts, half an amp, and then I've got my little leakage clamp meter. It'll measure down to 2 amps, down to the milliamp range, so 2 amps full scale down to 1 milliamp, and we'll plug that here in the X1. Okay, I think that'll work. So right now it's reading 498 milliamps, and this meter is reading half an amp. So let's go down. We can go down in voltage to drop the current, see if we can get down to where it just switches to 4/10. And there we go, we got 400 milliamps. That one's reading 401. So I think that's pretty good. Let's go down to 300 milliamps. So we'll go down to 0.3. And there we're reading 302, so that looks pretty good. And go down to 2/10, which is 200 milliamps. And there we go, it's reading 196, 199. Actually, I guess this one jumped up. It's a little hard down here because at the lower current, the light bulb starts cooling off. Yeah, we got 200 milliamps, 196. If we get down here, let's go down to 100. So there's 100.1, and here we're reading 104.7, 104.8. And then just for grins here, we can switch over to, I'll show you the X10 reading here. So what this does is it multiplies the reading by 10. So this one is showing about 106 milliamps. So this one, the meter's reading 1.06, but you have to divide that by 10. Yeah, 106, and this one is reading 110. So it looks like it's within, you know, half a digit here on the low end. And you can see the voltmeter There's 50 volts on that meter. There's 100 volts. Yeah, I go up a little bit. There's 100 on the meter. And if I go over here to the 150. So yeah, this meter's fairly accurate too. These two meters still work normally. And then I have the digital meter. Can read power and amps and watts. Yeah, so you just need to make sure if you're doing this modification that the voltage you're powering the meter with has a shared neutral with the load. For instance, I couldn't have my load isolated and try to power the meter off of the non-isolated input power, because this input power is isolated from the output power. And if I hooked up this line over here, there's no return path for the current that would power this meter. So it would be like you were just trying to use one wire to power the meter, because that neutral connection is built in there. So anyway, that's the one thing that you have to watch for, is once you break that power connection inside the meter, you're now assuming that there's a shared neutral connection, and you have to get that neutral connection hooked up properly. If there isn't a shared neutral, this won't work. You're going to have to power the meter off of the voltage that you're sensing. So anyway, if you have any questions about that, post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.